day 298. Make a song ringer. What's up, pizza? I just found this area where I could go to the store and come out of the store, and I was stuck in this mountain, so I reported a bug. Yeah. What's up, Hardboiled? Well, today I'm working on crafting. So, I'm going to fix up the bugs with the crafting. Good news, Hardboiled Egg. I got the bug fixed with the crafted bombs and, you know, like the fire bomb and the fire top hat and all that. It was a simple buffer overrun. It's really, really easy fix, but tricky to find, but easy to fix. So that's fixed. That'll be up in the latest version tonight sometime. And now I'm going to keep on working on this. This is, when I'm crafting items, there's a bunch of little bugs. You got your plot idea? Right on. What kind of plot? So, sometimes when you place an item and you pick it up, it just randomly... usually happens with the top hat. There. See there, it did the flux where it shows you that you just got the item. Yeah. What's up, Ahoy Clock? So yeah, I'm working on fixing that little bug right now. So I got some breakpoints set and stuff. Oh, I've already found out that it's not marking it as being crafted. So that would be in drop item, actually. What's up, State Off? Welcome, welcome, welcome. I mean, I'm having a great day here, actually. It's really nice to have so many bugs fixed and have the ratios all working really well, so it's all flexible. The game can run in different, like, ratios. Really smooth transitions now, too. So when you go from, especially on the overworld and in the dungeons, when you go from one area to another, it's like buttery smooth. And then, but there's a new bug because of that on the ship. There's some kind of issue when you go from one area to another. What's up, Nug Troll? Welcome. So when you actually drop an item, that's an input system. Drop item. I want to see that. You're a scavenger in a wasteland. After the outbreak. Whoa. Whoa, nice, pizza. Cool, I like it. Cool, stayed off. Thanks, man. Right on. Do you happen to know what version you're playing? Like, did you play it as of last night, my time? So basically as of like 10 hours ago, or no, as of about 12 hours ago, there's a new version. So I'm wondering if you're playing the new version or the old version. And yeah, by the way, State Off, there's also Trello. There's this Trello board with tons of bugs and stuff already on it and stuff. And I can add you to this too if you want to be added to this. So then you can post things here in this unofficial findings. And that way I can comment on them, or, you know, there's other people in here too. Boogie, Marza, Pedro, Pizza, they can comment too. Oh, right on. Oh, yeah, emails are fine too. Yeah, totally. But you already sent them earlier today, because I did not get an email from you. I was just checking my email a minute ago. Oh, okay. Right on, State Off. Nice. Yeah, either way you guys want to do that. If you just want to email me, that's totally fine too. Yeah, so there's some kind of bug where when it drops an item, Sometimes it doesn't mark it as being crafted. Let's see what happens when we drop the crafting item. Yeah, so all I'm working on today are just fixing more bugs related to this new alpha version. And later tonight, I got to fix up the marketing and get ready because I was going to market today, but there's just too many more bugs to fix. So I got to do the marketing to all. I got the marketing kind of ready to go. I just got to finish it and then get that done tomorrow. Interesting, it's already running the drop item. Oh, I guess that makes sense. Yeah, it would go and add it to the what's being equipped and all that. How do you use the Trello? Oh, you'll need me to add you. So if you're on here already, I can add you. If you're already on Trello. Oh, here's a link here. Here's an invite link too. I'll just post this in the chat. There's an invite link so you can use that. Wrong number. Right. Okay, so yeah. All right, so I need to figure out what's going on when I drop an item because it's not quite. Oh, you know what? That just has to do with number of craftables being two and the old re-equipping only being two and the new items there's four. We'll see what happens. So it should be grabbing the item, which is zero. Was that about? Why was the item zero? Must not have been equipped. Let's see. Pressing the button for the top app. That item's okay. If I press the button for the bomb. Oh, maybe the bomb is actually not equipped. Yeah, sword, nun, top hat, cup. Well, that explains why that wasn't working. I wonder if that's actually. From when it loads, so in game. Load game. Oh, by the way, too, I added it to Giant Bomb last night. Wonder if Giant Bomb got that. So hopefully you guys will be able to put it mark it as a game. What? Somebody gave it already has a torrent up of my game. And it's on GameSpot.com. Pirates are already sharing it. I guess I should take that as a compliment, but it's really not cool. Wonder if that works. Which is better, Xcode or NetBeans? Totally depends. What do you want to do? wonder if there's some way I can like mark this as. Like spam or something. Visual Studio. What do you want to do, cynical director? What is it you want to make? I guess it's not on Giant Bomb yet. I don't know. They haven't sent me an email yet either. Nothing yet. All right. Yeah, it's not there. Wow, who knows what this is? Oh, now it's only 529K. You can? All right. Let me save a link to that. I'll fight some pirating a little bit. Pirates! Pirates! Oh. Okay, back to it, back to it. Yeah. Yeah, no, totally. It's a random. Yeah, I know it's a random user. I know GameSpot would definitely not do that. I did actually have one re actual company that reviews other people. It's called The Stone Gamer. They actually gave away a link to my game for free to people. This was way back during the Kickstarter days. I can't believe it. Could not believe the audio's not working? What? Hello? Hello? Seems like it's working here. It is? All right, all right. Cool. What's up, Gutting? Welcome to the stream. Sorry. Right, good. Good news. The mic's muted? No, it's not muted. La 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 la. Yeah, it's good. Oh, sweet. Right on. What's it? What's this Indie Haven? Oh yeah, this is an article that Indie Haven wrote. These guys are good. Yeah, no, they didn't like share a link or anything. I was talking about Stone Gamer. She found a glitch to pass almost all bomb columns without having bombs. Nice. How do you do that? Oh, sorry. I forgot about the sarcasm. Yeah. I forgot about the kappa. So, sorry. So she teleported to the ship. Oh, and then what? So she teleports to the ship and then teleports back to the area. What's up, Jonah 19? Oh, stayed off. Wow. Nice. Oh yeah. This guy's too. These guys are great. Yeah, that's a bug too, where looks like you got around. Yeah, it looks like you got around it. Yeah, there's a gap between those and the trees. Yeah. Huh. If you happen to know about where you were and what world you're in, I can look at it, but I can probably find that. Okay, I'll add that to the Trello right now. Stayed off. You can bypass gates. Like a yellow bug. Stand really close to bombable pillars. Use teleport, return, and yeah, I understand what's going on. There's this function in the code which basically puts you in a good position, and it was since you're so close to those pillars, when it comes back to that area and tries to put you in a good position again, it realizes that you're too close, and then boom, it puts you in that kind of position. So that's important. But that's kind of a cool bug. Nice find. Nice find. Oh yeah, I want to see. All right, so I'm back here to debugging item crafting right now. So there's a bunch of significant bugs with the item crafting, so I'm just getting all that fixed up. So all right, when it first loads this gear and equipment, it's got sword, none, top hat, cup. That's crazy. Crafting, none, none. Yeah, hard boiled. There's not supposed to be any more. The shop icon behind the shops behind waterfalls are hidden. And so that was marked as a bug, as like, hey, there shouldn't be a shop icon here, but you know, it's just basically that's a hidden secret thing, so there's not gonna be an icon for those. And it doesn't happen in every world. Only some worlds have shops behind the waterfalls. So I don't know, what do you think about that though? Should it have a shop icon even if it does, even if it is behind a waterfall, or should that secret remain a secret? Totally open there. Spoilers, right? Yeah, that's kind of a spoiler. Sorry about that. Yeah, you're thinking no icons? Totally. What's up, Azimris? Okay, cool. All right. Oh, there you go, Pedro. Great solution. If you've been to the shop, then it shows the icon. Ah, okay. Let me fix that really quick. Yeah, cool. All right, let's do that. That's gonna be in game scene. Draw map. This is a pretty quick fix, so I'll just do that. I believe this world even has one. Social username. Do you work with game graphic things as well? What do you mean? I do art? Yeah, I do art. I work with Photoshop, as if that's what you mean, to make all the pixel art for this. We go. Store. So if it's not waterfall or visited destination. Right. And if I think I can test that in this world. Me just put the player really quick back in the world. I think it was actually negative 202. Is the store behind the waterfall? What's up, Boogie? Welcome to the stream. Yeah, pretty sure this is the one. Yes. All right, good. This is behind the waterfall one. All right, good. And look, it's showing that I've been there. Right? So my map has that as a store. Okay, let's double check all this. I'm gonna save my position right there. And take away the fact that I've been to negative 202. And it should forget that, and then it will become a secret again. Have you been self-learning yourself everything, or you went on education to learn coding? I've been a self-learner since I was 15 years old. I'm 36 now, so I've been self-learning for 20 years. Yeah, I did go to college for programming and all that, but it was after I'd already written games, so mostly self-learning. All right, good. So yeah, now we do not have a store icon here. It's just a, it remains a secret. But then if you find the secret, spoiler alert. Sorry. Come back out. And now you've got the revealed secret. Okay, good call. That's a good blend of both things. So it's secret until you've been there. Good call. Very good call, guys. Cool, Boogie. Whoa, Pizza, you got a lot of points, man. What's up, Chewy? I was watching your YouTube videos. Thanks, man. Cheers, man. Appreciate you saying that, Chewy. I really do. Thanks a lot, because it's very encouraging to hear that. So I really appreciate it. Oh, Pizza. Oh, Pizza, that sucks. So I don't know how that works. Is are you still here, Boogie? Like, did he did if Boogie, if you're still here, did he lose all his points just then by raffling it? I don't know how that should work. Is it should it be a raffle or what? I don't know. You guys tell me. I'm sure Boogie can edit that. Make bot foo. Okay, so he did lose his points. So what do you guys think? Should it should let's do a straw poll. I'll do a little straw poll on that. Straw poll. Should points be raffled or raffled and potentially lost? Or guaranteed winner. Raffle guaranteed. Right. Okay, here we go. All right, there. So yeah, whatever you guys want to vote there. What do you win? Okay, so your choices like you can get a you can win a Steam key. So that would be like you know if you want a copy of Sombria right now, it's the alpha version Steam key. You get gold backer status and everything. And then also there's also stickers that eventually you'll be able to win too. I haven't really figured out how to do stickers just yet. I guess I just got to figure out you guys' address and mail them. So, but yeah, so they're it's mainly just Steam keys right now. Okay, so going back to it did load something kind of weird here. It loaded no item and then showed me bombs anyways. Oh, social, yeah. Oh, sorry, I missed your question there, social username. Yeah, this is the almost 300 days in. That's development days. I've actually been working on this for over a year. All right. Okay, I know that it's not even loading that item as equipped, and then it's showing it equipped, which is weird. Oh. Pretty obvious, though. There. See it again. All right, Boogie, see you, man. BC Warrior. Right there. Okay, so it did not equip my bombs that time. Great. That's one little bug fixed. Great, 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 great. Okay, so the next thing is when it drops an item, trying to drop an item, it doesn't, something's wrong there. Is it working already though? Well, what you mean, Pedro? Let's see how we're doing here on this drop hole. Oh, wow. We're almost split down the middle. Okay. So, yeah, now that one tiny, oh, I gotta put the player back at the crafting spot. That was kind of a cool spot to be at. Okay. The points and the prizes? Yes, yeah, it works. It does work. So, but it will, it can, it's a raffle right now. So you have a chance of gaining the Steam key, or you have a chance of losing the points. I'm not into coding, so much, but you basically making your own game engine with this game included? No, I'm not making my own game engine. I'm using a game engine called Cocos 2DX. What'd you miss? Not much. We did fix that. If you weren't there, I did make it so that when you're it doesn't show the secret store until you've been there. Yeah. Slightly more important. Hey, what's up, Ethan? Ethan, I'm not sure I heard your new song. Which one? Oh. What's the chance? 1%? I don't know. Yeah, I'm not sure what the chance is. It's a really good question. Yeah. Oh man, I'm sorry, guys. I don't know what the chance is. Can you post another link, Ethan, to your song? Yes, I do know, Stadoff. They did finally announce that they are never going to have console ports of Cocos 2DX because there was actually a post on this on their discussion because Microsoft has all these NDAs and crazy restrictions, so they cannot share, even though they wrote all this code. And they have a renderer working for Xbox and everything. Everything was all good. They couldn't put it into Cocos 2DX because of their stupid restrictions. Same thing with PlayStation. So PlayStation also has all these crazy restrictions. So you know, even though the code's already done, kind of sucks. All right, Ethan, I'll check it out. Oh, yeah? Okay, so I dropped the top hat. What item do I have? That's item 0. I must have pressed the wrong button. So, drop the top hat. Right, so the item it dropped should be top hat. Yep, we got top hat here. That's good. This should be count. It should be definitely be a count item. So it's looking through crafting. If it already has it, it's going to return. What's the straw poll for? The straw poll is for, okay, so this is when you raffle out points, or when you're watching the stream, you get points. I'll post another link. And right now they're raffled out. So basically, when you get 1,000 points, you can submit your points for a raffle. So technically, your points are gone, and you have a chance to win a Steam key. So there's a chance you win, there's a chance you don't. And so the it's like basically this is the straw poll here is should it continue to be a raffle or should it be guaranteed that you can just turn in 1,000 points and get a Steam key? Right, it looks like it was able to allow it, drop the item. Turn off the item image, place the item. Okay, a couple things. This should be better. If the item is none, it should just return right there. And this should be count too. E.gear.count item is less than or equal to 0. Return if it's not a craftable item. Should return. Are you gonna have a port for Songbringer on 3DS? Probably not. Can't the guaranteed thing not kill your sales? Kind of. I guess it kind of would. I mean, it would definitely take out the fun of it too. Maybe the percentage should go up. I don't know. But no, it wouldn't really kill my sales. I'm not gonna, how many? It's not gonna be that often that people get 1,000 points and turn them in. So, and gosh, I want to reward you guys too. If you're watching the stream for 1,000 minutes, dude, that's worth something, right? Oh, or maybe programming bots. That's a good point, Sadoff. Right. Oh, I didn't think about that. Okay. Yes, it does, XPixel, totally. It costs a lot of money. It's very time consuming and to develop for consoles because it's just so much more testing work. Okay, I'm going to proceed with a different route to try and fix this. Actually, I'm going to see if it's already fixed. Let's see if I drop the item. Yeah, you were. There's a lot of people that were watching before. I seen the trailer for Firewatch? No, I haven't. Let me check it out. Hold on. It still does that. I think it's when it re-equips it. Crypt of the Necro Dancer. Cool. Suicide Squad? Yeah, I think I've seen that. Oh wow, this looks like a really pro game. This was 2014, though. Which trailer are you? Oh, here, this one maybe? Oh. You don't want to see this?
What's in this cave down here?
NFS tells people not to go too far in there. It's pretty dangerous. You're in it, aren't you?
It doesn't seem.
I mean, yeah, the graphics look great. All right. Yeah, it's this re I think it might be this re-equip crafting thing, which can m much more easily be this auto-equip item. Crafting eye. All right, so let's check that out. Oh, you meant for the Suicide Squad one. I hear you saying. Nice, Ethan. Cool. It's good to get a recommendation from a friend. Then you know it's got to be good, right? You trust your friend. Okay, this should be auto. It should be re-equipping this top hat item. Okay, good. That's gonna look through the equipment slots first in order. Good. And that was just causing the equip. That was basically doing this. It was re-equipping it, setting the item image. And also making it ready. Oh, which could have been part of it. Okay, so that should be better. Let's see if this fixes the bug. Okay, so top hat. Pick it up. Top hat. Pick it up. Oh, yes, I think it worked. Cool. Okay, so if I undo this, run it again, I think it will still have the bug. This game is good. Which one? Oh, I can't watch it because I'm not signed in. It says I have to be older than 17. What's the game called? What's my biggest game development project? This one. Yeah, definitely this one. It's the biggest game project I've ever done and the most successful game project I've ever done. And if you want to know how and why it was successful, I definitely would check out this crowdfunding article that I wrote. Fuso Young? Huh? Yeah, okay, so it broke. Awesome. Okay, that bug is fixed. So re-equip if necessary. That's auto-equipped. Great. That's one bug down. Bam. I'm not sure how to handle that just now, so I'm going to turn that off. That was called The Last of Us. Nice. Yeah, you got it. It's a great link, right? There it is, you guys. You're dereferencing a null pointer. Okay, the next parts of these bugs. Let's get into this Trello card. How'd this do with the... All right, we got 6 points to keep the raffle. I think this is getting to the point here where most of you guys prefer the raffle. I guess next time Boogie's on the stream, I'll keep this link up, actually. But next time Boogie's on the stream, we can tell him that most people prefer the raffle, but maybe that it had a higher percentage of winning. I'm not sure what the percentage is, so that's the thing. Thousand points makes you a moderator? Maybe. Okay, so crafting's messed up. There's a whole bunch of related bugs all here. Yeah, that's fixed already. The most important part is that when you craft an item like the top hat, it takes away your top hat. It's not supposed to do that. Nice. Last of Us trailer, huh? Is it possible to make an India game with the game engine using with the better graphics, something like the game Tibia from the graphic
view? What are you scared of?
Yes, of course. You can make whatever kind of game you want with whatever game engine you're using.
Do I need to remind you what is out there?
Once upon a time...
You love your zombie games, huh?
I had somebody that I cared about. And in this world, that sort of shit's good for one thing.
Or horror.
Getting you killed.
Looks like really great graphics here.
I need something smuggled out of the city.
What do we do?
Whoa. Not really my cup of tea. Yes, I did stop my no YouTube rule. I think El Capitan, they fixed it, because I haven't had that bug in a long time. I just did. Okay, so the point here is if I craft, like, fire with the top hat, it won't work. Better graphics, more coding? Not just coding, but art too. Art takes a long time to make graphics that good, like AAA games. You need to spend, a single model can take forever. So we got fire equipped. So if I drop down fire and a top hat, this crafting combination will work, but it's not. It will actually remove my top hat completely. So it gives me the fire top hat. But really, I should have the top hat and the fire top hat. Okay, so... I think I had this already as a bug. Yeah, can I craft bombs? These are the two things I need to do right now. If you already crafted a certain combination, it won't allow you. But this is the more important thing. The bombs, top hats, and blinks are going to remain after crafting. Yeah, totally pizza. All right, I think the first thing I should do is make it so fire, ice, lightning, poison, fear, all these are, they have two. Oh, wait, that might be how you would do a top hat. So the top hat could have a quantity of two. And then once you've crafted it, you would have a quantity of one top hat. Oh, that's brilliant. Yeah, okay, let's do this. Cool. Alright, that solves two problems in one. Okay. So, constants. Yeah, your mounds are looking cool. Nice, man. So fire, ice, lightning, poison, fear, all these are going to have a maximum quantity of two. The top hat is also going to have a maximum quantity of two. The ghost sword is going to have a maximum quantity of two. The blink also. Maximum quantity of two. Yeah, that should be it. Yeah, totally. I've definitely seen the game Kingdom. Do I watch the Big Bang Theory? What's that? Two, 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 two. Good. And also, these need a color. Fire, ice, lightning, poison, fear. All these should have colors. How many hours a day do I put into game development? 10 to 12. And I work 6 to 7 days a week. But that's because I'm a solo developer and I have to do, you know, a lot. I have to work a lot to make up for the fact that I'm only a single person. It's a TV show? Cool. I'll check it out. Big Bang Theory. Sprites. HUD. I'm going to grab the colors for these craftable items here. Like fire. Ice. Lightning. Poison. What's up, BLJ? cool, Ethan. What? That's not right. Ah, there we go. Fear. Fear is going to be like a black color, I'm thinking, but dark. Well, we could do this darkish. Like that. There we go. Now we got colors for those items. With regards to raffle. Yeah, that's totally true. Hardboiled is. What's up, Silly Billy Bear? Welcome to the stream. With regards to raffle, as it stands, I think it's 25% chance you'll win the Steam key. How about with each points over 1,000 will give you more chances? Oh, that's a cool idea, Jonah. Yeah. Awesome. I'll add that to, I don't know, I'll save your comment so at least I've got this to share with Boogie tomorrow. Call this raffle idea. I love that idea. Because then it stays as a raffle, but you can guarantee yourself a better chance. Definitely very, very nice solution there, Jonah. How does you implant your pixels art into the game? You just draw it. You draw your art, and then you export it to PNG files, and then it depends on your game. It totally depends on your game. But for my game, I export everything to PNG files, and then I use a program called Texture Packer, which packs it all into a sprite sheet, a texture. Let me give you a little example of what a texture looks like. There's one texture with tons of sprites. See, there's like just lots and lots of sprites for different entities all packed into this one texture so that it's efficient inside memory. When you load it into your GPU or whatever, all these things can be in one place rather than in multiple. There you go. Thanks, Jonah. What's wrong with the mic? I don't know. Is there something wrong again? You might try refreshing because it looks okay here. I want for the game, its current state is a proper windowed mode that I can move around the desktop and minimize and all that good stuff. Okay, so So the problem with windowed mode right now is that tiny black bar on top. Is that true, Hardboiled? And also, what happens when you try and run it in full screen mode? Does it just not work for you in full screen or something? Yes, social username. Yeah, that's how it works. That's how pixel art works. You make every single frame. Right? Let me show you an example. The main hero has the most frames because he's just got so many animations. See, here's one animation, and here's each separate frame of this animation. You can see it better if I turn on the background. Right, here's that animation for him swinging the sword, one of his sword swings. And so each one of these frames gets exported separately and then combined into one sprite sheet. Still can't think of a logo? Retro VGS? What? What you mean? What's up, Gutting? Who did you work with on Hero Bash? No, our company was called Esk Bros at that time, and it was a company I formed with my friend. My friend, his name is Christopher Horton. He's an amazing dude. He's currently writing novels. It does work. Okay, it's just that I'm usually doing stuff in the background while I'm playing, so the problem for me is that I can't move, minimize, resize the window. Man, that's a tricky one for me. I'll definitely try again for that to get it to work better in windowed mode. The problem is I don't have control over creating the exact window, but I do have control over editing the window later. The problem is when I the window gets created with that with the because it's in windowed mode, it has a title bar at the top. And when it has a title bar at the top and you resize the window, for some reason it will not resize the OpenGL view, so it's a tricky thing, but I'll definitely take a look at that again. You need a logo for your game, and what is RetroVGS? RetroVGS was a system that they were going to make to bring back cartridges, but now it's called something else. I think it's called the Coleco Chameleon. It's on Facebook. Facebook, RetroVGS. Yeah, it's called the Coleco Chameleon now. And they're going to be doing an update, I think. Yeah, this is, I've already read this one. They're eventually going to do another Kickstarter for it, but it's some, I think somehow they partnered with Coleco. I don't, I have no idea what's up with that, but yeah, they just changed their, 'cause their first crowdfunding attempt failed for lots of reasons. Oh yeah, space shooter, cool. I know Retro VGS is way better. Yeah, I definitely agree that it was a better name. Yeah, I will hard boiled. I'll definitely try again. In fact, let me just make sure that's a Trello bug. I'm sure there's got to be a way to get that working, so I'll find it. So there, it's definitely noted. Yeah, I haven't seen all those remasters just yet. Cole Cam. Born to Snipe, what's up, man? Since the console's under different peeps, does that mean you lost your deal with them being not necessarily. It's not different people. It's the same people that are still doing it. I just have no idea what's up with them because they keep emailing me and saying, "Hey, we need to talk." And then let's schedule something for this week. And then they never ever call me. So I have no idea what's up with them. But yeah, when I finally figure out, I will definitely let you guys know. So okay, so this is gonna be Quantity 2 when you pick up fire, ice, lightning, poison, fear, the top hat, or the ghost sword. That's going to be in pickup item. Needs to give a quantity of 2. Eye container, bomb container, key. I think it'd be better to put an actual function for this, so to mark these as. Like set max quantity or something. Yeah, thanks, Born to Snipe. Am I done with every characters in the game? No. No, I'm not. And I definitely do a lot of Photoshop work. I'm not during the current days because I'm doing a lot of bug fixing. I'm releasing the game right now. This is an alpha update I'm releasing right now. So there's mostly bugs I have to focus on, which is code. So, but yeah, normally on the stream I do a lot of Photoshop, and sometimes I do music work too. I do my music in Ableton, and sometimes I do that on the stream. What's up, Caleb? What's up, Wheels? Yeah, they stopped allowing the game dev category. They force when I start streaming, it forces my category to creative instead of game dev. I don't know what's up with that. I haven't seen any news. Have you guys seen any news from Twitch on that? I haven't heard anything, but I'd like to know. I'm debating whether I should put a flag for this or make this just regular. Just like kind of do a janky quick. Yeah, I'll do a flag. So whenever you pick up an item that has this flag, it will. It will give you the maximum quantity. So this, oh, actually, this should be called maybe give max quantity. And there needs to be a constants method to check that. Constants.h is max quantity. Let's call this do give max quantity. There, get that compiling. Pizza. I don't know, Beetle. I don't know how that works. Yeah, it looks like it's all creative, just tag game dev now. Yeah, I think they forced it. I don't know how they did it, but or yeah, I would love to see some kind of official announcement there, but I don't know. All right, where did I put this? I put it right after is stockable item. Calling this one do give max quantity. All right, there we got this function ready. Now, the one items that I need to apply this to are fire, K give max quantity, fire, ice, lightning, poison, fear, top hat, ghost sword. Oh, and also blink. Okay, next I need to make sure that these are gonna all work. Huh, so they didn't release any information about it, huh? Yeah, Twitch did it. Twitch forced it. Social username? No, the alpha is not free. Sorry. There's been a Kickstarter. So if you look at the links for this game, if you just go to the webpage, it's songbringer.com, there's a link to the Kickstarter. The Kickstarter, there's a bunch of great, amazing people that backed this project back in March. Or April, May, something like that. And all these people pre-ordered the game at like $64 to be able to play the alpha version. So in honor of them, that's why it's still $64 to play the alpha version today. And the beta is $32. And if you just want to buy the game and pre-order it for when it finally comes out, that's $16. Oh, there is a game dev thing, huh? It's on Reddit. We are transitioning programming and game development directories into Twitch Creative. Okay. We believe programming and game development are inherently creative acts. I do too. In order to create a central place for all forms of creativity on Twitch, we're transitioning the programming and game development directories into Twitch Creative. Okay. This transition allows us to offer dedicated support for broadcasters from programming and game development. Creative team is actively growing. The existing programming and game development directories will redirect to their respective hashtags on the Twitch Creative. Okay. Programming, game dev. Oh, and broadcasters are selected for promotion. Wow, that's kind of cool. Our goal is to create a platform where you can share your software development. Oh, so there's more info on the Twitch Creative FAQ. Awesome. That's pretty cool. You like how the prices are power of two? Cool. Reading days? Do you want me to read to you some more? So back to give max quantity. I need to make sure this all works for all these types of items. So in pickup item, none of these should be ending life, diamond. None of these should be one of those types. So top hat, here's one. Actually, this should be constants. Get max, get item max. And that can be duplicated for other situations too. So yeah, when you first pick up the top hat, you're gonna get a quantity of two. The only thing that sucks about this is it is going to kind of break. Well, crafting's already broken for existing save games anyways. But if you want to fix your save games, you're going to have to fix them manually. So That's to be something to be noted for any of you guys that are playing already, like Hardboiled or Pedro, Boogie. Basically, you want to go in and hack your save game and change fire, top hat, some of these other items here. Like, especially whatever you want to craft, it needs to have a quantity of two. Keys, maps, compasses, those are also... Yeah, I'm not going to do those just yet. Life container, quarter, unlock exits, everything else. Okay, here we go. So, if constants do give max quantity for item not type, then we're going to set the max quantity. Otherwise, we're just going to increase the quantity by one. Then it auto equips it. Okay, so first thing to test out is I'm gonna remove the top hat from the player and save that location. Go back to the overworld. We're gonna fight the first mini boss again. Archage, huh? You just won't craft? Oh, Hardboiled. So, yeah, let me repeat that really quick. Basically, after tonight's update, once I go and finally update all this code, you're gonna want to, if you want to go back and craft items successfully, you want to set whatever items you're crafting to be quantity of two. So, if you want to craft your top hat, you need to have a quantity of two, and if you want to craft it with fire, you need to have fire of two. So, both these things need to be two, and then after you've crafted it, your top hat quantity will go down to one and your fire will go down to one, but you'll have the fire top hat also. So if that makes sense, basically just anything you want to craft, put it to quantity two. Yeah. Thanks, Beetle. Okay. So let's see when I fight this guy. Should be able to pick up the top hat. I can save the game. I should have two top hats now. Or the quantity of two. Good. And if I run the game again, there should be no problems in the menu for that. Yeah, cool. I've just got a top hat, it appears. Nice. Very good, very good. Yes, exactly. So you're gonna, yeah, because you lost your crafted items or whatever in those save games. I'm just mentioning that for you. If you want to fix your save games, if you get tonight's update and you just start over completely, it'll be fixed. So, but if you do want to play an old save game, you'll need to do that fix to be able to craft stuff. Okay, next I need to test out, like, picking up a fire or something, you know? Fear, whatever. I think one of them was in negative 202. Cool, right on. What time is it? It's time to get ill. Ugh. I think it's like 4 o'clock for me. I'm not sure. Oh, both you guys are at 0043. Whoa, it's 5:43 for Beetle. Oh, in the afternoon. Okay, now I picked up fire. Should have one here if I save. should have two. Oh, it didn't work with fire. That's weird. What happened there? Check the constants. Fire. Give max quantity. Should, okay, and pick up item. Did I mess anything up there? There's no item fire in this whole file, so it should have gone, fallen through all the way to here. I'm just gonna double check. How long game time are they gonna, are they gonna be? How long is the game to play? It's like usually about 5 or 6 hours you can complete the game. If you're really quick though, you should be able to get it done in under 2 hours. If you're like super fast, you should be able to get it done in like under an hour. If you're really, really slow, then it could take you longer. Oh, in the morning. Okay, so I'm picking this up. Should be do give Mac one. Oh, what happened here? Why is that? What happened to that? Okay, so stepping into this method, something's wrong here. Cadams find I. It, what's our it? We got back index pointer value CC first 13. That should be what is item type? Yeah. Okay, item fire. Good. It's the right item. The second is the flags and all that. We got flags of 8. I think that's wrong. Flags of 8. That's not, yeah, that's definitely not right because that's shifted up 7. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. What's wrong with that? Craftable is 1 shifted up 3. That's 8. Okay, so it did get the craftable flag, but it, when it tried to or on the give max quantity flag, it didn't work. I wonder if I need to make those 1LL. Make them longs. Yeah, let's try long. Well, wait, what? It could be the item fire. These are unsigned. These should be fine too. Unsigned min, max, unsigned flags, price. Price is the last one. Let's just double check that. Price is 120. Yeah, that's okay. No way, Scottish Peace is Scottish. He's Scottish. Can it be really hard sometimes to solve bugs? Yes, it can. But the more you program, the more you learn programming, the easier it gets to solve bugs because they just become, I don't know, you become more familiar with how code works. You become more familiar with how your own code works. And it just gets easier and easier. You made some calculations regarding the raffle chances versus time. Posted the results in Trello. Thanks, Pedro. Cool. I'm sure Boogie will take a look at that. Still, totally, wind does make it colder, right? It's a curious one. I wonder what's up here. Give Max 20. Oh, it worked that time. What? That's so weird. One shifted up 7 should still be within the bounds of even a single, right? Let's go to programmer mode. The number 1 shifted up, no. 1 shifted up, what? Uh-oh. 1 shifted up 7. It's only 128. That's crazy talk. I don't know why it wasn't working before. Is it maybe this enum? Oh, it could have been the enum. Like an enum value of 128, but that still doesn't make sense. Unless enum, this enum type was a character. I have no idea, but it's working now. Okay, so if I run this again, turn off breakpoints. Dungeon crawler, cool. Spiders, clowns, no wizard stream. How about all 3 of those? Oh my god. All right, so now we should have 2 fires. Yes, good, we got 2 fires. Beautiful. The blink should be the same thing. Let's find the blink. Oh, I have no idea where blink's gonna be. Oh, unless maybe I turn on dungeons. Ah, you know what? I trust that it's working. I tested it with this. Let's try. I guess we could test one more. So instead of fire, we could test fear or poison. These all have give max quantity. I know these are gonna work. Okay, let's get on with the rest of this bit of code. So now that we've got quantity of 2 for both of these, we can go and make them. Make them craft together. Oh yeah, this one? Yeah, I've seen this one, Jonah. Yes. No, it would be like, I don't know, I'm one of those people that has to finish everything I start. So that's why you see me here every day. Because I love doing this, this is like my ultimate creation in life. I love creating this game. And this is my ultimate game. This is exactly what I would create given the chance. You know, this is the exact game I would want to play. So there's no, yeah, don't worry about that. Songbreaker is coming out this year. It's going to be awesome. Hopefully it will be awesome. It's definitely coming out, that's for sure. Okay, so yeah, now back to the area where you can craft. I have 2 top hats, 2 fires. Let's equip fire. It's really easy. And then put the player back here. Right, the dual analog. True, I totally agree with you, Beetle. Yeah. Fire is not equipped. What's up with that? Thanks, Hardboiled. So I can equip it, but I don't know why it's not being equipped right away. Alright, gotta go back to the drawing board here with game. When it loads. This is all kinds of messed up, actually. Oh, it's because it's I'm on the area. So really, you should never be able to save your game with the fire equipped. So, this is not the main bug. I gotta work on a different part of this. Do I still have to look up code commands? No. I'm pretty familiar with all those. Let's see what happens when I craft two of these, or when I craft these together. Wait, what happened to that? He's cool. He's like, yeah, I can craft those. Put those together. See what happens. Thongbringer, yeah. Cool. Got the fiery top hat. But it did use up the top hat. Okay, so this is not gonna work. Yeah, so we wanna reset that. So fire top hat 0, top hat 2, fire 2, equip the top hat. Okay, and back, okay, so where it actually crafts items, and that's in flux. Here's where it places the item. That's not the one we were looking for. This is where the new item appears. Yeah, this is where it gets the craftable item. I don't think this is where it actually removes the item from your equipment, though. There's a lot of phases to this whole crafting thing. What have been the toughest parts in making this game? I guess the toughest part was the very beginning when I was working on it full time, but I had no income except for so a little bit of like income making web design stuff in my spare time, which I've had barely any of. And I was just barely squeaking by, making no money. I was streaming this game every day. And I was about to start the Kickstarter, and I had no idea if the Kickstarter would work, you know? And the art wasn't that great compared to it now. And it was a very hard psychological struggle. you know, to work on something that you believe in, right? But you don't know if other people believe in it yet. And so, but that was also one of the best parts of this whole game was after the Kickstarter succeeded, because it verified that yes, that people do really want this game, and also that I had the funds to do it, which was like the hugest relief. So that was the hardest part of making this game, was taking that risk. It was a huge risk to do a Kickstarter. It was a huge risk to make this game when I didn't have the money to make it. That's before the Kickstarter. You got stuck in the cup dungeon? Oh, hard-boiled. Sorry, man. Okay, let me write that down. Cup dungeon cannot be completed because you can't, because there's no switch room. So there was, so Hardboiled, there was a big boss door, but there was no switch room. That must have been something I changed recently. That's, I guess, one of the most important bugs. Sorry about that, Harbod. Have you thought about giving Jib passive defense skills? Yes. Yeah, he's going to have something. He's going to have items. And there's already, I think there's already one of those listed here. Making him be able to craft. Foo Wizard, what's up? Beetle J, did you check out the crowdfunding article? Check that out, man. Check it out well before you ever do a Kickstarter. Okay, so what I'm working on right now is making it so crafting items is way more rock solid. Right now, when you craft a top hat, for example, you lose your original top hat. You're supposed to keep your top hat. So it's because I've changed the way items and stuff work since I've worked on the crafting. So I just have to get the crafting working again, basically. So let me remind myself how phase craft works, or the flux craft. Where the hell is the phase craft? Phase craft. Oh, it places an item if it succeeds. Oh, so it's just place item, which is just walk to, and then K phase craft. Actually, I'm gonna go look for K flux place item. Yeah, pizza, I know. Yeah, I know you're Foo Wizard. I saw that. Wizard food? Hey, thanks, Zeladongs. Wizard food and Foo Wizard. All right, Jonah, good night, man. Oh, whoa. Nice PC warrior. Let me hop in on this without ruining it this time. Yeah, see that? I check my spelling before I click send. Okay, so this is where it lists the item on the ground. This gives it a crafting index. gives it the spot. That's it. It doesn't even take away the item or anything. Oh, but it does when it's done. In the place item function. It's place item. This is pretty critical to how all this works. Yeah. Ugh. Is it possible in the future with an expansion when the game is done and doing well? There probably will not be any expansions. There will be free updates though. I don't really like the DLC thing. I don't really like some of the models of how people make money in games lately. I'd rather release this game, make it awesome, and then make it even more awesome with free updates. I know, right? When I call for food, it's true. Yeah. Oh, that's pizza? Pizza's got wizard food and wizard food wizard. This just creates the item. I'm looking for where it takes it away from the gear. It looks like it doesn't. Oh, it doesn't. All right. Phase craft. Right, so I won't be removing Dungeons 4 and 5 and including it as downloaded content. Exactly. It's exactly what I'm not doing. You're just Food Wizard? Wizard Food is a mystery character! Right, it can be legitimate. Totally, it can be, yeah. I think it just kind of gets illegitimate so much of the time. But yeah, it's legitimate if it's one, a substantial amount of content, and two, not enough to just be a separate game. Right, yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay, I'm looking through this code, how the crafting system works, to remember how it works so I can fix it. At some point, it's got to change the dot has. It didn't. None of that. Yeah, none of that changed the quantity. Never gave the player an item. Oh, like a whole new story? Yeah, if there were a whole new story, it'd be a whole new game. So yeah, I do have plans for more games beyond this. If Songbringer succeeds, it's a commercial success and all that, and it funds the next game, which it hopefully will, then yeah, I've already got some ideas for what there will be, but it will be a second game. It'll be like Songbringer 2, or the story of another character, or the continued story of Rock and his quest and all that, something like that. Magician Foo. Greetings. Yes, if I have a lot of money, I know a lot of people that I would love to employ. That's for sure. Oh, I know what to do. So when it starts the phase craft, I can just set a breakpoint and see what it's already done. Duh. I'm pretty sure it might remove the items from the player's inventory the second you drop it. So I drop the hat. Now the fire, and it starts the phase craft, and the player has what? What is in their inventory? I definitely removed them from being equipped. Oh, it won't show me what's... Oh, damn it. It has them in the crafting, but I'm pretty sure it removed it from the equipment. Oh, I wish it showed this. Damn. Alright, well, let's do a quick loop over that. So for auto item in e.gear.has. That's going to be e.gear.count item. Oh, this is a pair. It's going to be auto ref pair. Pizza for payment. Hire me as your boss. Done. I need a boss. Who doesn't need a boss? I want a boss like from the Life of and Times of Tim. Have you guys seen that show? It's so great. If you haven't seen the Life and Times of Tim, amazing show. Get item key for pair dot. Oh, pair dot first, not pair dot item. And then this is dot Caesar. There, so now it'll loop over and show all the items when I start crafting. Your magician food too? PC warrior. Wizard fool. How you came in contact with Steam and releasing your game? That was part of the Kickstarter. I did a Steam Greenlight. If you don't know what Steam Greenlight is, look that up. Steam Greenlight. There we go. All right, so look at all these items. Has zero of this, zero of that, blah, blah, blah. We still have two fire, good. We still have two top hats. That's good to know. Okay, good, good, good. Wizard full, the condition wizard foo is in after eating wizard food. Isn't wizard foo a singleton? Wizard foot? This is the most ridiculous stream. I love it. Here we should also have all the items. You can see I'm debugging in a pretty janky way, but oh well. Okay. Picks up the items, drops the items off, picks up the second items, returns to the middle, charges the laser beam. Runs, a new item appears. Let's do another breakpoint there. turn to the bench, pick up the new item, drop off the new item. And yeah, this is the end. So set the last breakpoint there. Run all those. Not Foo. Have you regret not having a partner to work with during the game development? Actually, the exact opposite. Social username. Whatever the emotion is for the opposite of regret. I love being a single solo developer. I love, you know what? You wanna know why? Because nobody tells me what to do. I mean, I can do whatever I want. I can create whatever I want. And there's no red tape whatsoever. There's nobody saying, you should check with blah, blah, blah with that. Oh my God, it sucks. It sucks being a creative person and having someone else tell you what you should do. Or even having a partner in your project to be like, hey, partner. Can I do this in the game? Is it okay if we do this to the game? Is it okay if we add this feature? Is it okay if the character does this? Is it okay if the character does drugs? You know, like all these questions you have to ask your partner or whoever you're working in a game with. I hate that. I completely hate it. I love being my own person, making my own game and doing whatever the hell I want. And so this is the very first game I've ever done this. I've never had art skills before, so before I started this game, I started drawing stuff, and I started getting better at making art, and so I finally had the confidence. I was like, you know what? I think I can do it now, and so I can make, you know, when I started this project, I finally realized I could do all my own art, my own music, and my own code, so I was like, there's definitely no way I'm ever getting a partner for this game. So, you know, that could change in the future. I might change my mind, but probably not. There is a Bafu. Jifu. Yes, Stadoff totally said it. Singleton. Yeah, there's caveats too. They're totally. I mean, it does kind of suck having you're bearing all the responsibility, doing all of the work. You know, there's pros and cons to every kind of situation you're going to be in with game development, whether you're with a team, whether you're on your own. Wizard Food can tell him what to do. You can. You can, Food. Food, you have control over me. I must eat. I must eat to survive. Okay, where is this? This point, we still have it. This is after crafting. Run it again. This is at the very end. It never ran through one of its phases. Because I sat here the whole time. It ran through the phase without doing it. I still have two fires. Two top hats. Oh, this is crazy. I don't know what's going on. I kind of do what you guys tell me to. It's true. That's what this Trello board thing is. But ultimately, it's my choice in the end whether I do it or not. But yeah. Yeah, stayed off, totally. The stream is a great way to get feedback but still be in charge, totally. It works. It's an amazing thing. And I'm constantly thankful for your guys' feedback and stuff because, gosh, without all this amazing feedback you guys have given, I don't think the Kickstarter would have succeeded. I probably wouldn't even be making this game anymore because the Kickstarter wouldn't have succeeded. What constructive feedback he gets. Uh, 3D checkers, not solo? What? You mean monster checkers? Yeah, that was a solo project. It seems to me if you're going to do a partnership, it's a good idea to avoid sharing responsibilities. Yes! That's a really good point, Salad Dongs. Right, yeah, totally. Good example there with Thomas Happ, too. Yeah, You really got to set some boundaries with your partner and be like, okay, I'm going to completely handle this part. You're going to completely handle that part. You know, but I don't know. I don't know how to navigate those waters successfully. I've never done it. Yeah, social username, I know what you mean by that, but it's still, when somebody else is responsible creatively for something, it's hard, because I would be like, oh, sure, I would hand off a piece of art to somebody, but what if they create art that totally sucks and I hate it, you know? It'd be hard for me to tell that person, you know, I hate your art or whatever. But it's easy to tell myself, okay, this art sucks, I need to make it better. You had to buy 10 pre-orders? No. You got it for being amazing. It's true. Pedro's been around a lot for a lot longer than a lot of the people here. Actually, a lot of you have been around for almost the whole time. Hell, you guys have been all around, I'm saying. But Pedro's done a lot of amazing beta testing work, and he's a great guy. That's why he's a mod. Yep, that's why they're both mods. They both have really contributed a lot to this project already. This is probably the most productive stream yet. Definitely. I've gotten like maybe 2 lines of code written so far. I'm still clueless as to why. It must be when I pick up the item. Yeah, okay, let's turn off these. All these breakpoints inside. Here, all these flux breakpoints, disable, and then in pickup item, I'm gonna set a breakpoint here and check the entity, see what he's got. Yeah. Can you trade in mod stats for 10% share of your profit? Doesn't work with that way. All right, there we go. Run that. You're a fool for trading your mod status. It's true. You never know. This game might not even make any money, and then your 10% would be worth nothing. Okay, tell me. Oh, shoot. It's not going to show me what equipment he does have. Wait a minute. Oh, there it is. It clears them right there. Finally, I found it. Oh, I've been looking for this piece of code forever. Awesome. Yeah. Yeah, I did get something done today. That's right. Found this. This should be 1. There, so the things you were crafting now have a quantity of 1. Boom. Okay. Now, all these should be correct. Fire 2, top hat 2, fire top hat 0. All right. Let's craft this once again. Plays RuneScape. What? Yeah, we were just talking about Punch Club yesterday, and how it has had a really interesting marketing strategy. You know, with their Twitch play being the first experience people had with the game. Okay, so I'm picking up this item now. Damn. I don't think it worked. We still have one top hat. We still have one fire top hat. And we should still have one fire. Okay, they did work with the numbers, but why didn't it show it on the inventory anymore? Yeah, Twitch plays Songbringer. I think that's going to be a thing. I know it'd be some work to get all that set up, but I think that should be done. Oh, now I have it. This is so odd. And it's marking them as craftable. What's your thoughts on the game RuneScape? You mean the old RuneScape? I don't know which one you mean. I haven't seen, if there's a new RuneScape, I haven't seen it. But if you're talking about the old RuneScape, I thought it was pretty cool. I played it with some people way back in the day. Mamor. Puga. No, please do not apologize for your questions. It's absolutely okay to ask whatever question you want. That's what I'm here for. Yes, yeah, taste is a good... Yes, Songbringer does have hardcore mode. It's called permadeath mode. And when you're in permadeath mode, it's just like any other permadeath mode. When you die, you can't continue that save game. And it's basically the speedrun mode. It does have some more features where it makes it faster for you to speedrun. Yeah. Okay, a couple problems with that last craft. One was that it was weird with the inventory afterwards, but secondly, it's allowing me to equip these items. All right, and craft them. So now that I've already crafted it, it's allowing me to craft again. I think all we need to do is go into Flux. Oh, actually, no, there's two places where these need to be checked. It's like a get craftable combo. Get rid of these little debug statements I don't need anymore. And yeah, there's like this function, it's called get craftable. Maybe it's called get craftable item. There it is, get craftable item. Okay, this function here, I think it has something about, it needs to check the quantities. Yeah, this definitely needs to check quantities here. All right, pizza. See you, man. This is looping over constants, CADM combos. Wait a minute. It found. Oh, wait. Would a memorp be possible? Maybe. We'll see. It really depends on whatever the hell I want to make, you know? I know, that would be a hard one to make solo, for sure. I have done multiplayer before, though. That's definitely a hard thing to do. Yeah, personally, I'm with you, Hardboiled. I'm definitely love this style. So I probably this a Songbringer 2 would be probably be something in the same style, but even more, maybe even more procedurally generated, or like maybe even procedurally generating art. You know, like something really rad. I don't know. We'll see. Or I might just tell the story of some back characters, like Vel, the girl character. It might be a really fun thing to have a whole game about her story. Her story is like 10,000 years, takes place 10,000 years before this story happens. So that could be a cool story to tell. Yeah, totally. If people are liking it and digging it, definitely I'm going to keep building this universe. Combating cheaters. Yeah, it is. It definitely is. It's hard. Same thing as fighting pirates, you know? It's like, yeah, possibly. Oh. So if we found this craftable combination and this has, or this count, i.second.first. equals constants get item max. i.second.first, right? So if we have the maximum quantity of this item and the maximum quantity of the second item, i.second.second, then we can craft. Otherwise, we cannot craft. Let's see if that works. Songbringer movie. You never know. I mean, shit. A lot can happen in 9 years. Just use a bigger sword. A game about Jib when he was human? Yeah, that would be cool too. Yeah, definitely. Jib's definitely one of my favorite characters, so. Alright, so I can still equip the top hat and the fire. That should no longer be possible, but I should not be able to craft these. Yeah, he's all unhappy because that's no longer a combination. Oh, thanks, Pedro. Looks like I'm gonna be getting going soon. I can tell because I'm hungry already. Wizard food! You got me again. So I'm going to put a comma here. Return the item combo if has a max quantity of elements. Combos, elements, whatever. Combos, items, sub items. Thanks, Stadoff. What's that thing that follows him as a pet? That's Jib. He's a character. He's a character in this game. He used to be human. Yep, He used to be human. He's a robot now. He's a flying little robot, and he helps you out by scanning enemies' bodies. And he's also eventually going to have little like items, like he like a little weapon or stun gun or something. And also, there's going to be local co-op play, so you can actually plug in two controllers to the same, you know, game, and one person gets to play the main hero, and one person gets to play Jib the robot. So as Jib the robot, you're really more of a support character. Did someone say food? I did. It's almost time to eat you. All right. Now the next thing is to make it so you can't equip the top hat, those other items. I think I need to create a brand new function for yes, eat you. this is in Flux for Phase Gear. Yeah. There's going to be more of that story 2 stuff shared. I'd like to do some more posts to the Steam page, actually, and tell more about the backstory. I can't wait to share the backstory with you guys, because I've kind of gotten into the whole universe and how it was all created and stuff, and what races of people came to be, and why Rock's race of people has those eye visors and stuff. There's this one line of code, which that's a black item, makes the item black if it's... on the... Oh, here it is. If it's a smith. Yeah, if it's a smith and it's a not craftable, it disables it. Oh, it's just this, is craftable item. And why he doesn't have a shirt. Yeah, that's kind of part of the main story, right? When am I releasing the first book? Rocky Balboa? No, I think he's going to... I'm not sure how he loses his shirt just yet, but I'm pretty sure it comes off in the first bike crash. And then you just never find another one. At least for the first game. Maybe there will be a shirt, but there'll be a lot of sprite frames I got to redraw to have a shirt for all that. But yeah, it would be probably worth it, right? To be able to get a shirt. I do have the shirt already drawn for some walking frames. So yeah, this is going to be the last little bit of code I do today. I'm going to make this so if it checks a quantity, if it has the flag, okay, give max quantity. And quantity is less than constants, get item max for it first, or I, it's just I, then return false. There, let's just see that. find out who stole the shirt. Yeah. It's true. Yeah, or maybe he took it off in the space party, right? Which is basically, that was kind of the idea at first, is why does he not have a shirt? Because he's going to a party. Oh, good. Okay, great, 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 great. Okay, so now we got a black top hat. We should also have fire. No, it doesn't even have fire. Huh. But it should have it still in the quantity. Okay, so let's see that one last time. I'm going to run the game one more time and just make it so we'll do this whole craft again. So it starts with the top hat and fire. No fiery top hat. We'll craft these together. How many parties do you go to as Topless Foo? How many parties do I go to topless? At Birdie Man, as many as I can. Or in the summer. Heck yeah. This is kind of like a summery game, I guess. But there is rain. I don't know. Oh, now I can't drop it, though. Messed it up. Oh, I totally messed it up. So if I take this code out, I guess I gotta rework this code even better somehow else. Yeah. In slow mo. A montage of Rock walking away from explosions? Totally. That's his last name, Epimetheus. He rushes in before considering the consequences. That's his character's flaw. Okay, well, this works, but I gotta fix this other function. So there's a lot of work left to do on this whole crafting thing. But hopefully by tonight I have this fixed and uploaded so that y'all can play this and craft items again. A pinup of him on Songbringer? I don't know which Rock would win. Okay, well, let's see if I warp back to the world, if this will work. Oh, that's right, this is a bug. Yeah, great. Okay, but at least this is working now. So before there was a problem because you lost your original top hat and you couldn't do the crafted one. So now you have technically two items. You have your fiery top hat upgrade and you have your top hat drone still. So this will work. You can actually craft items again. This is good. This is one step in the right direction, but there's still some work left to do with this crafting. Which one is the real people's champion? Haha, I don't know. You know, I question they team up, obviously. All right. Well, that's it for today's stream, guys. Got to get some other bugs fixed tonight. Got to get some food in me. Got to get some wizard food. Social username, it was 15,000. But check it out. Check out the Kickstarter page. You can get all the details on that. Yeah, see you guys. Appreciate y'all. Have a great night. The alpha version's coming out tonight, and I'm going to do marketing tomorrow for it. So, we'll see ya. Have a good night. Restore your mana.